Now, this is an ABC Action News Update.
Good evening to you. I'm Jasmine Stiles. Jason will have your forecast in a bit, but first, here's your ABC Action News Update. With the Omicron variant threatening Christmas gatherings, President Joe Biden is expected to give a speech. A White House official says he'll address the growing number of cases, hospitalizations, and deaths heading into the holidays. That's happening on Tuesday. If you're rethinking holiday plans now that COVID-19 cases have doubled in the state, an infectious disease expert says it's important not to panic. He adds, as long as you're vaccinated, washing your hands, and staying home when you're sick, you should be able to celebrate safely.
We're not at the point where people should not, you know, take this time and celebrate the holidays with family and friends. They should, but they just need to be careful.
Unfortunately, the pandemic isn't over, so while we're in it, you can look to us for information to keep you and your family safe. Just go to abcactionnews.com/coronavirus. We also have an update on breaking news from Friday afternoon. After a plane crash in Auburndale, police identified the two victims as a Winter Haven couple. Police say their 70-year-old John Smalls III and 62-year-old Lynn-Ann Kerr. The couple's plane crashed in Lake Arrieta. The FAA and NTSB are investigating that crash. Now let's check in with meteorologist Jason Adams.
It's going to be another warm one here on your Sunday, but we do have winds coming in off of the Gulf of Mexico, so that will nudge temperatures down just a couple of degrees. We'll likely stay below the records, which we have not been doing for the last few days. So as we're into the low to mid 80s for highs, inland upper 70s, lower 80s at the coast, there also could be just enough moisture coming in off of the Gulf of Mexico for a slight shower chance from Pinellas and Hillsborough County north. Not any kind of a washout. This is noon Sunday, partly cloudy skies and warming up. If you have the outdoor plans, enjoy it. But just note, as we go to 4 and 5 o'clock, there could be just enough moisture coming in off of the Gulf of Mexico that may give us a little bit of a rain threat. Hopefully for the game itself at 8:20 here at Raymond James Stadium, not too worried about rain chance at that time, only around 10%. Let's fast forward into your Monday, overcast skies with more clouds than sun, and that's all due to a cold front that's going to eventually make its way here with an area of low pressure as we get into your Tuesday outlook. So while the rain chances stay at 30% Monday, Tuesday, we up the rain chance to 70%, and then a big cool down follows with temperatures only into the 60s by Wednesday.
Thank you, Jason. That wraps up your ABC Action News Update. We're on 24/7 on abcactionnews.com.